brand new, it's starting. So I've got a very small team that has been, as you know, when I came to your studios, the question was, are you going to run? And I said then, I'm seriously considering. So I've now made a decision. So the launch or the activities to put it all together start now, because I couldn't have done so before I made up my mind. But I kept being literally badgered by people that this is a call I to come up to answer. And I made up my mind, and now I decided it was time to come as promised and let the people know that I've made that decision. So, but and also during that process, people were also, because I was going to run as an independent, but people said, you know what, we hear what you are saying, but we don't understand the whole structure of independent. So hence the conceptualization of APA, and now we start implementing.
Right.
What needs your country? And my experience, you know, where were you? Where did you study?
Republic.
Have you ever been outside the country?
Once.
Where?
South Africa.
And what? When you went to South Africa, what did you think?
It's different from here.
In what way?
Infrastructure, everything, just everything.
Yeah, but it was not always like that. You know, when Zimbabwe got independent, when were you born?
1992.
Uh-huh. So you don't know the some of it. Okay. So when Zimbabwe got independent, do you know that Qantas used to fly into Harare and not into Joburg? Yeah. So Zimbabwe actually, because we got independence ahead of South Africa, we became the hub for Southern Africa. And slowly but surely, we squandered it. Yeah. And it is clear to me, when you consider that the South African economy relies heavily on skills from here, the British health system relies heavily from nurses and doctors from here. We've got everything it takes for our country not to be second to any other. And so my view is, I'm well traveled, I've worked all over the place, and I think Zimbabwe and Africa as a whole is not in the place where it should be, because the potential is there, the people are there, and in the case of Zimbabwe, the work ethic of Zimbabweans is unbelievable. It's second to none in the sub-region, that's the honest truth. So other people are building their countries on the back of our investment in education, in technical training. It appears to me that we have to change it, and I think I can help change it.
Right, Doc.
Always we say it's in the leadership. So what I'm offering is a leadership to do things differently. Start with the role of government. What is the role of government? I don't believe that the role of government is to do things for people. But I also believe that the role of government is not to get in the way of people. So government should create an environment for young people like you, entrepreneurs, to get on and achieve and get satisfaction from achieving. That's the role of government. And if I look at our economy, for instance, we've got investments by government in mining. We've got investments by government in tourism. I would say to you, it's completely unnecessary. Government needs not to be a player, but a regulator. And create space for investors, because they are there. Create an environment which investors are happy with, where they feel that there is a fair relationship of investing and getting a return, and get out of it. And the more you make a government do all of these things, the more capacity you build in government, which does not create money, absorbs money from the economy. So shrink government and be clear about its responsibility for a start. Be clear about your economy and how it should work and where you should intervene and where you shouldn't intervene and just regulate. Be also clear about the relationships with the international community. I'm a financier by background. If you come to me wanting to borrow money for your company, I understand, and you should understand, that if you don't do certain things in a particular way, I won't give you the money. Right? Yeah. If I don't see the potential in your project, I won't give you the money, because you're going to lose the money. And our relationship with the international community has to have the same discipline. In other words, we need to understand what the rules of the game are. We're going to play in that space, we're going to get resources, we're going to get investors. There are certain rules we have to. We cannot be an exception. The whole world works according to certain rules. I understand all these things. And so those are the things I would have to offer, which I believe, up to now, the evidence on the ground demonstrates we've not complied.
Right.
I am offering myself as a leader. I do not want my concept of what this country requires to be diluted by somebody who's got a different vision. That's why I gave you the example of water and petrol. You end up with nothing if you're not careful, because a coalition dilutes. So I think the Zimbabweans should be offered the opportunity So one leader comes and says, this is what I believe in, this is what I can do. And the Zimbabweans look for themselves to see whether that is right or wrong or not. I will do the same, and the Zimbabweans should choose without this dilution, which I think is completely unnecessary. It's a dilution in order for politicians to give each other jobs, not a dilution in order to deliver to the benefit of citizens. And I don't want to have anything to do with it. Any correct question from especially somebody as young as you, who perpetrates violence? Young people, actually. It's young people. You are the ones who perpetrate. You are the ones who allow yourselves to be used for beating up people. But the evidence, again, you have, you are not stupid people. You are very smart people. The evidence right in front of you is that your future is being put at risk every day. I mean, are you able today to buy a house, buy a car, provide for your family? The circumstances continue to shrink. So when you go beating up people, what are you beating them for? Instead of facilitating an environment which will nurture debate, which allows the leaders to be put on the spot. So what would be good for this country is for instance, President Mugabe, President Morgan Tsvangirai, and myself to be on a platform and debate without anybody getting beaten. Debate what we're offering the people so that the people can see and hear and then choose. When you beat up people, what are you trying to achieve? You shut them up. How are you then going to know who to choose? But I'm saying it's in the hands of you, your generation in particular, to do two things. Firstly, get clarity on where you want your life to go, where you want your country to go 10, 20 years from now. Yeah? Then come back and compare that to where the country is today. You know what that does to you? It almost like structures the kind of things that need to be done to take you from here to there. And that is close to being a job description of what somebody should have in terms of skills in order to help you, work with you, partner with you to create that country of the future. That's all you need. And then you go and make a choice from those who present themselves.
Great.
It is a tricky question. Your relationships with other people, you don't even have to go international. Do you work in the same office? Yeah. So your relationship with this lady depends on how you behave. If you behave in a manner that does not do anything for her, she thinks everything you do is inimical to her interests, she won't work with you, right? International relations are the same. They're exactly the same. So if you run in country B and I'm running country A, and I behave in a way which does not conform to what you think is conducive to us having a partnership, then you won't work with me. So whether we get relationships with international communities that are conducive and supportive will depend on how I behave. It will depend on how I behave. Do I think I would behave in a manner that would be problematic? I would like to think not. Do I think I might have problems with some nations and not others? The answer is yes. There are some nations that I would find it easier to work with, and there are others who I suspect it will not be easy to work with. But that is normal.
Let's talk about
that. Depends on what question I'm asking. What, when you say that, what is the question really? What is it you ask me to deal with?
You know, they need to put closer to the issue.
And so what does that mean?
Yes. How do you plan to put closer to the issue?
I would like, so it depends on what are the issues that Gukura Wundi gave rise to. There are some people who lost loved ones. There are some people, young people like you, who probably have got no documentation because they'd run away and so on and so on. I can solve things which are a problem today, like if you don't have documentation because or your circumstances made you flee and therefore you almost like stateless, we'll deal with those issues. What I cannot do, and with all due sensitivity, what I'm trying to make people understand, I cannot, and nobody in fact can, give life back to those who lost it. And what I'm trying to persuade my fellow Zimbabweans is that just like we did with Ian Smith, we need to be able to make a distinction between trying to resurrect the past as opposed to creating a completely different Zimbabwe of the future. That's what I'm trying to say. I would like people to come together and say, we commit ourselves to build a new Zimbabwe in which a Gukura Wundi will not happen again.
All right. Since you, okay, fine, just a minute. You seem to take care, I mean, to take greater cognizance of the need to have youth in your party?
I want to make youth understand that I've got the capacity to work with them to grow an economy that will create livelihoods and secure their future. And I think if they cannot be persuaded by somebody who's going to work with them to secure their future, then I do not know what will. Because what are you interested in? Where we came from, you are interested in securing your future, your children's future, your grandchildren's future. And that's what I will be offering youth, that we work together to make that happen.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.